years ago, I met Guy Willison. He designed and built with his 5.4 brand, the CB1100 RS Special Edition. Now a great package, a lovely 80s endurance replica, but since then, the man's been very, very busy. Guy, good to see you again,
Hi,
mate.
Yeah, good to see you.
Now, obviously, as we can see here, we've got the CB1000R.
Yes.
You've been very busy in your little workshop.
I have. Obviously, the 1100 has been a great success, and I just wanted to, if you like, move it on a bit more modern. I'd had my eye on these from the previous model that's kind of similar in a way, very, very similar. And I saw it and I just thought it's the perfect bike for the 5.4 treatment. So that was that, and we're on where we are today.
Now, a great bike in standard form.
Yes.
Just enlighten us exactly what you've changed on this bike to make it look as good as it really does.
Well, basically, I took all the things I like on that one and tried to enhance them and embellish them. And the things I didn't like, I've kind of changed. So, you know, the various bits and pieces, there was, it's got the single-sided swing arm, which to me it's not unique in the bike world, but it's pretty special. Not every bike's got them. It was kind of largely hidden by the standard can. And I thought, I want to show off that single-sided swing arm. And also this model's got the new kind of multi-spoke wheels, which are also kind of hidden. And by changing the can, it reveals all that. And I think it looks really special with that single-sided swing arm. So that went on there. This model doesn't come with a seat cowl, a standard. So I wanted the seat cowl that is on the black edition. And Honda done a great job styling that, and I wanted to enhance that. I put traditional, if you like, 5.4 leather seat with a 5.4 stitching pattern. I love that pattern. I haven't, for me, found anything that I prefer. So there we go. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. So it's got the red stitching on the leather with the individual padded diamonds. So I think it's more comfortable than the standard, and that's just a nice place to sit. You can ride that all day.
And branded with a 5.4 badge, of course.
Yeah, I've had there was a bit of a hoo-ha, you know, with me about that. I tried embroidering the 5.4 logo. That really stood out. I don't want it over-branded, the bike, and I think that's really subtle. When it's in the shade here, you can hardly see it. When it's in the sunshine, you can. It's just a subtle little nod to it being a 5.4. And so I rather like that because it's subtle.
You know, I've been riding this all morning, fabulous. It's got the quick shifter on this model.
Yep.
Now, just running through towards the front, obviously with the front end, we'll talk about the paintwork in a moment, the mirrors, the levers, just talk us through that.
Well, the usual 5.4 thing, the bike has to work for me. So this bike was crying out for some kind of nose cone. For me, it was an absolute given. I like them anyway from a styling point of view, and they have some sort of function. Look, it's not a tourer that's going to keep you dry in the rain, but it will take a bit of wind blast off you and give you a little bit more of an easier time. So it has that function, but look, I make no bones about it. I've done this for the style and the look. I think it was crying out for something to go on there, and I spent a long time on it, just getting all the lines right. You know, the swage line in the middle lines up with the top of the tank, the bottom one lines up with the middle of the tank, and I just tried to put, you know, a more sporty, kind of urban looking thing on there that enhances the front of it. To me, that's a whole world better than having nothing on there.
So different mirrors, different short levers, they're beautiful actually, really good feel. Well, personalised with a 5.4 badge on the front and numbered.
Yeah, we've got these billet aluminium mirrors. They're just beautiful quality, you know, they're just special, and I think they're in keeping with all the other sort of like candy paint and LSL levers and leather seat. You've got to have nice wing mirrors. So yeah, you know, we have to have a 5.4 badge on the front. It's the usual nickel plated enamel badge, got the limited edition number on it. I like that. It makes the bike special. It's a part of it. You've got your individual number. Every bike's individually built by me, not a team of guys. So I pour my heart and soul into it, and you get your limited edition badge on it. The paintwork, well, I think a lot of people know now, you know, I cut my teeth biking from the age of 17 onwards, going endurance racing, watching Le Mans, Spa, the Bol d'Or, and I used to watch these Hondas racing in, this is my take on their paint jobs. No two were the same, so there isn't a standard format anyway, and this is my take on what I remember them looking like. But this one, rather than the 1100, this one's in candy. Just because it's a more modern bike, I thought it would wear it well. And also it shows off the lines of the tank. You know, you can see the swage line for the knee cutouts, you know, the raised bits on the tank, the folds in the fairing. You know, if you see a black tail piece, you just don't see the lines in it. That Honda have beautifully put in there, but they're kind of hidden with a black one. This enhances them.
Now, a gorgeous stubby little Race Fit exhaust.
John at Race Fit is a mate of mine. I've got a special link up with them. They've let me put the 5.4 logo on. It's now laser etched in, it's not a sticker. And also I like that burnished blue with the candy blue paint. It's not exactly color matched, but it's kind of in keeping with it. It's titanium, it's beautifully welded. And of course it's got the rogue red rivet because it can't be perfect.
You've changed the rear a little bit to fit your special tail tidy.
Yeah, I mean, Honda have done a beautiful tailpiece on it, which is fantastic. I love it. It's got the leather bum pad on it with the 5.4 logo laser etched in. The candy paint shows off the beautiful lines of it, and I think it is a gorgeous shape. But, you know, I wanted to show off the whole of the rear tyre. A lot of modern bikes have those hugger things at the bottom. For me, just on a personal level, I prefer to see the whole tyre. You know, going back to the endurance racers, when you could see the whole of the rear tyre and it had a beautiful pipe like the Race Fit on it, that's what floated my boat. So to achieve that, what I did was, I put a slimline LED rear light, which what that allows me to do, all the bracketry to mount the rear number plate and the light is all internal. There's not that I've seen anyway, someone will probably tell me I'm wrong, but I've not seen another tail tidy where all the bracketry is inside. So it's got beautifully clean lines underneath. There's no scaffolding outside. So by fitting the LED rear light, it's a slimline one, roughly the same depth as the indicators, so it's all in keeping. It sticks out a bit at the back, and I think that just looked bang up to date. And I love the look of that light. It's radiused underneath. It's a bit like an arrowhead underneath.
So I noticed this machine is 00. That's Honda's bike.
It's got a pre-production prototype in essence. We want all the numbered ones to be available to the public. So this one's for Honda themselves. So it's badge 00. So 01 upwards will be available.
I see, it's got your signature on the rear tailpiece. Does that mean every model will have that?
Do you know what? That is open to debate because I've put that on there without any permission because Honda are very good. They do leave me alone to do my own thing and then I present them with a bike and hopefully they like it. So far, there's never been any arguments. They've been really supportive and great. So I had an owners club meeting and a couple of the people with the 1100s have bought their tailpieces back because I signed one for one of them. He put it on social media and a couple of others went, oh, could you get mine signed? So at the owners club meeting, they were going, oh, when's the new model coming out? I'm saying soon. And they said, you should put your signature on all of them.
And of course, after this beautiful job, what's next?
Well, what's next is I've got to get these built because I do build them all myself. So we've got to let the dust settle, see how this goes. I have got my eye on two other 1100s in the Honda range, both of which I'm actually quite excited about, and I might just get one and build it anyway and then take it to Honda without having any prior arrangement. If they don't like it, well, I'll keep it.
Mate, before all that starts, let's go and enjoy the rest of the day.
Yeah, fantastic.